Hello friends, welcome to another video on Microsoft Fabric. In this video, we will explore how to use Dataflow Gen2 to load data into data warehouse. Previously, we looked into the Dataflow Gen2, we were able to write the data to lakehouse. Here we will explore whether we can do whether we can use Dataflow Gen2 to write data to data warehouse. Let's get to Power BI service and take a look. This is a warehouse we are working on. If you're following my Microsoft Fabric videos, we have one data warehouse called FabTUS DWH. If we go to get data, we get two options here. New data pipeline. We already have this video on this particular option, like how we can use a data pipeline to load data to data warehouse. But there is another option called new Dataflow Gen2. Let's take a look at that, how we can use it. So I'm gonna go new Dataflow Gen2. So if we look here, here we have in Dataflow Gen2, and we can get data from various sources. I'm gonna import it from an Excel file, which is on my OneDrive for Business. Let's click that and browse OneDrive. So once OneDrive has opened, I have some folders in there. We're gonna go to try test. And I have a sample file called per.csv. We're gonna pick that one. Of course, there are other ways you can connect to the other sources as well, but we're just exploring, like the purpose is, can we use Dataflow Gen2 for the purpose of loading the data into the warehouse? So I go select and next. This is a CSV file. We're just seeing the data here, and we're gonna go create. I'm not going to do any transformation and all that stuff because there's nothing is that sort of required in this case. Now we will see the preview of the data here in the data flow. So this is perfectly fine. So these are two number column, integer, and then the one is text. Last time when we loaded the data to lakehouse, we use the option lakehouse. And now we have two options here to load data to the data warehouse. There is one Azure Synapse Analytics SQL DW. Actually, this option was not there. Few days ago, it showed up in here. So I'm gonna use that. And of course, then it's gonna ask us the server information, all that fun stuff. Now, we don't know because this is a SQL Server endpoint, because it's a SQL Server endpoint. What we need to do is we need to get the SQL endpoint of our data warehouse. So what we need to do that, I'm gonna cancel this. Let's save this. And one of the good thing about Dataflow Gen2 is to highlight here that you can actually save as in a draft your data flow without publishing it. So I'm gonna say, are you sure you want to exit? I'm not publishing it, I'm just saving it as it is. So say yes. For whatever reason, the data flow which we just saved as a draft was data flow 4 is not showing up in this list. Again, this might be a small bug here. I don't know. But the point is, we were looking for the SQL endpoint for our data warehouse. To get the SQL endpoint for our data warehouse, what we're going to do is going to our data warehouse, which is FabTUS DWH, and click on these three dots, and then we're gonna go to, there's a copy SQL connection string as well. You can copy it, or we can go to the settings, and we can see it here. So we can copy it from here as well. So I'm gonna copy this. Now we will create the data flow again. So what we're gonna do is, let's go back to our data warehouse, which is FabTUS data warehouse. Again, when we saved it as a draft, it should have listed here without publishing, but I guess it worked in the past, but I guess as everything is in preview and things are changing on the fly, so maybe there is some issue. So let's go back and recreate data flow again and connect to the CSV file from my OneDrive. Keep in note, at this point we are doing the Dataflow 7 and I'm going to again use OneDrive to import my Excel file. Okay, here we are again. Keep in mind, this is Dataflow 7 and we have loaded the Excel file from my OneDrive for business folder. And to destination, what we're gonna do in this case is, again, we're gonna use the SQL data warehouse. And then we will give our connection string, which we already copied from the data warehouse connection string. And the database name in this particular case is, again, going back here, another window we have, that is fab test DWH. So that, let's put it in here, fab, that's our database name. And I don't think this is a case sensitive, but let's put it the exact name. And of course, it used a connection string already, organization account. I tested it previously before recording, and that's why the connection string is in there. And otherwise, you have to give your username and password and all the information. So here you go. Now it is going, okay, new table or existing table. We can just have another name of the table. I'm gonna call it per test. That's the name of the table, what would look like in the data warehouse. And of course, we can always pick up the existing table and use the append option as well if we needed to, or replace as well. Again, it's exist new data. What we want to do here is append or replace. So it automatically pick up the type of the columns from there. That's part of the transformation we have in the Power Query. And then we're gonna go save settings and publish. Here you go, Dataflow 7 is here in our list. I expected the other one to be sold, to be shown, which we saved as a draft, but for some reason it did not work. Now it is publishing it, doing all the validation. This is the one another good thing about Dataflow Gen 2 is, of course, you can save as a draft and then come back and publish it. Once you publish it, it immediately close the window so that you can work on other stuff, and then it do the validation in the back end. So it has completed the validation and then it start the refresh process. This is another one thing which I don't think I'm very fond of about, like, should it automatically start refreshing running the data flow after you publish it, or should we have a refresh option, and or should it be manually refreshed once you have successfully published the data flow? It automatically start the refresh. I don't think I like it, but anyhow, that's how it is working right now. And once this finishes, and we expect to see a table in our in warehouse. And let's look at the refresh history, what's going on right now. Okay, it's in progress. It said it succeeded. I think reading of the table has been succeeded, and there should be a write to the data warehouse as well. We have to wait. Okay, so the refresh is successful. So let's see what we have. So, okay, there is a read the tables, and then it has written to the destination, which was data warehouse. Let's go to data warehouse, which is our fab test DWH. And we expected to see per underscore test table in there, which is again loaded from data warehouse. No, sorry, from Dataflow Gen 2. Here it is, and let's run a query because I'm a SQL guy. I test everything using SQL, and here you go. Select star from test and run. Here you go. We have a data in our data warehouse using Dataflow Gen 2. Previously, we did this using data pipelines. One thing I really want to point out here, and let's go back to our data flow, which is the one of the important information I want to talk about. Let's go back to our data flow 7, and we edit it, And one thing I want to show here, remember the flow we used, we went to the data warehouse, we selected load using Dataflow Gen2, and then we connected to the file and created the data flow, and then the destination was the data warehouse. It is already here. If you look at the data destination, it says SQL Server Database, right? Because we gave the SQL endpoint. Now the question comes is, add data to the destination here. If we remove it for a second here, let's remove this data destination. And now we have the option again to add the data destination. The question comes is like, okay, I used SQL DW. It asked me the data warehouse endpoint, SQL endpoint for the SQL data warehouse. Can I use the Azure SQL database as well? Because if I have that SQL server name and the endpoint, can this be used Azure SQL database instead of Azure Synapse Analytics SQL database? So let's try that. I'm gonna go with the Azure SQL database. And again, it's the same thing. It's asking for the connection string. We're gonna give, we already have that SQL data warehouse, the data warehouse endpoint. We already have a SQL endpoint of the data warehouse, which we just pasted here. And then our database is fab. Test. Sorry, my machine is super slow today. DWH, and it will automatically pick the connection string because I already have. I can always add the connection if I needed to. So I go next. So now in this case, instead of using the Synapse Analytics data warehouse as an endpoint, I use the SQL server as an endpoint again. It's asking like, do you want to create the new one, or let's create the new table because we just want to test it and call it per test one and next. Again, append or replace, doesn't matter what option, the same functionality here, save settings and publish. Again, with the publish process, it is probably going to do the validation and it will refresh. So we will wait on the refresh, and after the refresh is, oh, I got some error here because I've seen some unknown errors in the past as well. Again, it's a benefit of doubt. Everything is in preview, so there must be something going on. But what I found is, regardless of whether I use Azure SQL Server endpoint or this SQL data warehouse as an endpoint, they both are looking for the SQL connection string, which is, I just got it from the SQL data warehouse, and doesn't matter whether I use the Azure SQL database or the SQL data warehouse as the endpoint in my Dataflow Gen2, it does create and work and create a load the data into the data warehouse. Maybe when we will use a load to data warehouse using Dataflow Gen2, it will automatically fill up that connection string information, and we don't have to manually input that. I don't know. But I didn't see any difference between using Azure SQL database or the SQL data warehouse as the data load in Dataflow Gen2. They both are again looking for SQL connection string. But it's good news is that we can load data using Dataflow. If you're coming with the background of Power Query knowledge and the SQL knowledge, and you can really use data warehouse, and you can use your M knowledge to transform the data and load into the data warehouse. Let me know what you guys think about this video on Microsoft Fabric. This is the fifth video, and a few more videos are in the pipeline coming soon. Do subscribe my channel. Until next video, have a great day. Thanks for watching. Bye for now. Thank you.